Rapunzel, get over here and stop gawking at that lady's god-awful artwork. I don't want my daughter to get infected.
r/entitledparents.
Our first story we'll be reading today. Idiot entitled mom doesn't want her daughter to catch my autism. From user must love Disney movies. After that, entitled granny tries to take first base. From user Mr. Pokemon. And then we'll be finishing up with some pro revenge. Cheat on me? Steal from your former roommates? Have fun being pregnant, alone, without money, a bad credit score, and no roof over your head. Ouch. From user Delec Debugger. Thank you so much to our authors for letting us read your stories. And if you're an author who would like to hear your stories on the channel, please submit them to the r/MrReddit subreddit. And welcome to the newest members of the Re-Army, Amber Dark, Shaba, and Thick Nico. And if you're new, join the Re-Army by subscribing for new stories from Reddit every single day. Idiot entitled mom doesn't want her daughter to catch my autism. Hey Mr. Reddit, hope you enjoy my r/entitledparents story. So you all remember how in my first ever post, I said that since all the people in my life were decent folks, that I'd never have to deal with an entitled parent or person? Yeah, I may have jinxed myself, since this is my third encounter with one thus far. Just happened earlier this morning, and I'm still a bit amused by this woman's stupidity. As usual, I will be paraphrasing words used to make the post PG-rated. Backstory. I was diagnosed with Asperger's syndrome, high-functioning autism, when I was 3. I have struggled with social skills and such all my life, and I am a lot more comfortable with people either much younger or much older than myself than with people my own age. Hence why kids seem drawn to me, I guess. Cast. Since I am a Disney freak, I will be naming the characters after Disney characters. We've got me, Mickey Ears. We've got Mother Gothel, the entitled idiot mother. Rapunzel, Gothel's sweet daughter, probably about 5 or 6. Mrs. Potts, kindly older woman in the waiting room. Mom, my awesome mother. And Dr. Dawson, nice doctor who works at the office my family goes to. Unlike the great mouse detective character, this Dr. Dawson is a woman. I couldn't think of any female Disney doctors off the top of my head. Story. My mom had an appointment with Dr. Dawson this morning, so I opted to go with her since she would be doing small errands afterwards. My mom has bone-on-bone arthritis in both knees and has a hard time moving around, and since I'm the only one of my siblings who still lives at home, I often escort her places. Mom was called into the examination room almost immediately after we checked in, and I was in the mostly empty waiting room. The only other person besides myself was Mrs. Potts, who was quietly reading one of the magazines the waiting room offered. I had brought a backpack full of crud to entertain myself, so I dug out my drawing pad and colored pencils and started doing some drawings. Enter Mother Gothel, who had Rapunzel by the hand but was barely paying attention to her as she checked in. Once she was set, Gothel then practically dragged Rapunzel over to the area where I was seated and started messing around on her phone. Rapunzel noticed the drawing I was working on, a princess drawing appropriately, and came over to me. Rapunzel.
Wow, that's a cool drawing.
I look up. Oh, thank you. I love to draw. Do you like to draw?
Yeah.
Gothel, finally looking up from her phone.
Rapunzel, get over here and stop gawking at that lady's god-awful artwork.
Okay, mommy.
Goes next to her mother. Now, I know I'm no Frida Kahlo, but I didn't think my drawing was that bad. Surprise, surprise. As soon as Gothel went back to her phone, Rapunzel goes back to me.
How come you have Ariel wearing Cinderella's dress?
Sometimes I like to draw how I think the different princesses would look wearing each other's dresses.
Oh, that's cool.
Gothel snorts, not even looking up from her phone this time.
Please, that's a stupid idea.
Note, she said a word instead of stupid that starts with an R that I refuse to repeat. I'm sorry you feel that way, ma'am. I personally think it's fun, and I'd appreciate if you didn't use that word.
Why, are you a stupid person?
She uses it again. No, but I do have autism. She immediately glares at me.
You have what? Are you insane? Are you trying to infect my daughter?
Excuse me?
Rapunzel, honey, come here with mummy. I don't want you catching that lady's autism.
I'm looking at Gothel like she's insane. You do know autism isn't contagious, right, ma'am? You're either born with it or not.
Don't give me that crap. I know all about autism. You probably got it from some stupid vaccine, or hooking up with your brother or something.
I had heard the theory of autism and vaccinations before, not the other one.
I don't want my daughter to get infected.
Mrs. Potts has been quietly listening in.
The young lady is right, ma'am. Autism is a neurological disorder. You can't catch it at all.
Oh, shut up, you old bat! You don't know what the heck you're talking about!
Turns back to me.
Why don't you just do us all a favor and drop dead and take your stupid autism with you?
At this point, I'm trying hard not to cry and to keep myself from slapping this woman silly. Luckily, my mom and Dr. Dawson came out into the waiting room right then. My mom.
OP, what's wrong?
This stupid girl is trying to give my daughter her autism.
One, that stupid girl is my daughter, and I'll thank you not to talk that way about her. And two, she can't give your daughter her autism, because autism is not a contagious disease. Dr. Dawson.
Ma'am, I can confirm that what she says is correct. Autism is not contagious, nor is it caused by vaccinations.
Shut up! You're all trying to make my precious baby sick. All of you are out to get her.
Ma'am, if you don't stop this behavior right now, I'm going to have to ask you to leave.
But I have an appointment!
Then you'll have to reschedule. Gothel growls at me.
This is all your fault, you stupid cow. Autistic new buddies like you should be euthanized.
Mom turns bright red. Get the heck away from my daughter right now, or I'm calling the police. Gothel realized that she's not going to win here, so she stormed out, dragging poor little Rapunzel with her. Dr. Dawson apologized to me and my mom, then went with Mom to finalize the bill for today's appointment. Mrs. Potts came over to me and tried to comfort me, complimenting me on the drawings I was working on. I thanked her, then gave her one of them, a picture of the actual Mrs. Potts from the movie, which she took delightedly. I don't know what online crud this woman was reading to warp her mind, or if she's just naturally that idiotic, but boy howdy, was that something. Next we've got, Entitled Granny Tries to Take First Base. First time poster, and I'm on mobile. Cast, we've got me, brother, Ent, entitled Granny, but she is an Ent since her skin looked like a tree, and my dad. Little bit of some backstory. My family, growing up, was a bit obsessed with baseball, and if it was baseball related, my dad didn't care what my brother and I did. Usually we threw and hit to each other on the road since we lived in a cul-de-sac. If you get it into the neighbor's yard at the end of the cul-de-sac, then you got a home run. Now, it being the great state of Minnesota, we had a lot of snow on the ground as usual. So my brother and I still wanted to play, so we set up our gear and a homemade wall in the street so the balls wouldn't always go all the way down the road when we missed them. There were many times that we would hit the ball foul and it would go in the lady's yard. It would happen often since she had two massive pine trees as well. On this particular day, we had quite a few baseballs in her yard. And once we finished the bucket, we started to pick them back up. Well, when we started to get the foul balls from Entitled Granny's yard, we were about halfway through the balls when we heard some yelling.
Hey, you kids, get the heck off my lawn!
We looked at the house, since that's the direction the yelling came. We see through a window on the top story an old lady staring hard at us through the screen. My brother.
Who are you? And we aren't hurting anything or destroying your yard.
No! You are destroying my grass with every step you take on my yard!
Keep in mind, it was winter, and snow was everywhere in her yard.
Lady, we're just picking up our baseballs. We aren't playing in your yard.
Entitled Granny huffs and shuts her window, and we thought that was it, so we gathered up our balls and I started to pitch to my brother who was hitting now. About 10 minutes later, the old, angry, and three-legged woman slowly stepped out of her house and starts to yell at us again for destroying her grass. My brother just looks at me and tells me to just keep throwing, so I do. All the while, Entitled Granny is still hobbling with her cane, coming our way, yelling the whole time. She gets close. I mean very close. Entitled Granny tries to position herself in between us, and at one point, I threw a ball just 3 feet from her body. Thankfully, my brother didn't swing.
the heck do you kids think you're doing out here? You could have hit me or someone else.
She didn't seem to care about herself much, seeing as she tried to walk in my pitching path. Lady, can you please move and leave us alone? We have been playing here for months now, and no one has had any problem with our playing.
You kids are destroying my yard and my beautiful pine trees with your balls, and you are obstructing traffic.
We always would move our things when the rare car came into the cul-de-sac in under 30 seconds. Traffic was not an issue. But the lady would not budge. She would just stand there, expecting us to apologize for playing baseball. My brother ran to get our dad while I was stuck with this hag. In the 2 minutes we were alone, she would just keep telling me about how we are destroying her yard when we stepped into the snow, and how the grass will not grow anymore when spring came around. Well, my brother finally came back and told me to pack everything up, we are done for the day, and that our dad would talk to her after we ate, since he was busy cooking dinner. So when we started to pack up, she would just huff and puff like she was going to blow our gear into our garage for us. During dinner, my dad would talk about how we are just having fun, and she probably is cranky since her leg is hurt and she lives alone and such. After dinner, my dad went over. Now, he didn't let us come along, not that we wanted to, but told us that conversation went like this. Hello, my name is blah blah blah, and my kids were playing on the street, and you told them to stop?
Yes! Your kids are destroying my grass and breaking the branches with their balls.
Ma'am, the grass is frozen because it is under a ton of snow. Also, grass is made to be walked on, and they are playing outside and having fun, and most definitely not destroying anything. Our dad tells us that they basically repeated the same sentences a few times, and it ended with her slamming the door on him and saying he is a bad parent for letting us destroy her yard. We did have a couple more run-ins with entitled Granny, but she never came out of her house to yell at us anymore, but she would occasionally yell from her window. But we would just keep playing. Not an amazing ending. Sorry for that. However, now that the years went by, she has since passed, and a nice young couple lives there now. And our final story of the day. Cheat on me? Steal from your former roommates? Have fun being pregnant, alone, without money, a bad credit score, and no roof over your head. This might be a longer post, so I hope you bear with me. Also, English is not my native language, so please excuse my typos or spelling errors. Also, this whole mess happened about 3 years ago, so most of the conversations are not 100% exact. Also, I don't really know if it's an entitled person, a choosing beggar, or a revenge story. So I was dating this girl for about a year. Everything went well, and we were happy. We were living in different towns, but it was only a 50-minute train ride, so it wasn't that bad, but still a little annoying. When a room in her shared flat became free, we talked a little about it and decided rather quickly that this was actually a good opportunity for us to move in together. So we planned a little more, and I packed my things and moved towns. The shared flat consisted of 6 people in total, but the main protagonists are my girlfriend and myself. Since I come from a rather big family that wasn't much of a problem for me, they knew me, I knew them, we got along perfectly. After I moved in, the girlfriend told me that the person that moved out was actually the person that signed the lease and that we need to vote for a new one to sign it. After talking about that little road bump, we as a group came to the conclusion the two of us can't sign it because they were 4 months away from their finals and already looking for new tenants to take over their rooms. Two flat out said they don't want to sign it, which pretty much left girlfriend and me as the only ones to sign it. So we both decided we will sign the lease together, which was an idea the landlord really liked. Fast forward a month. I got a job in an old people nursery home and worked mostly at night. Girlfriend just started a job at a gaming hall and worked mostly during the night too. As far as I knew, everything was going great. Until girlfriend knocked on my door.
I just wanted to tell you that I found a new tenant who will take over my room next week.
Since we were pretty much using only one of our rooms anyways, she thought that we could just move in together into one room. Oh, great. So, we are moving into one room together. I wanted to talk to you about that too. Glad you came in first with it.
No, I am moving in with my boyfriend.
As far as I know, I am your boyfriend. I mean, I was your boyfriend last night, this morning, and if I'm not completely mistaken, we were still together 20 minutes ago.
Not really, but I thought I should at least tell you that I'm moving out next week.
After she said that, she turned around and left. I was still sitting at my table, still not really knowing what just happened, and with what I believe had to be the biggest question mark in the universe on my face. After 5 minutes, I stood up and went to her room. So, just that I understand you correctly, you were telling me that you will move out next week to move in with your boyfriend.
Yes, that's what I said.
Okay, you gotta help me here. As far as I know, I have been your boyfriend for the last 14 months. Or did I misinterpret something there?
No, you have been a boyfriend for that time, but I started seeing the other one 5 months ago, and now I think I should move in with him.
At that moment, I just turned around, got my jacket, and went to a local bar. The rest of the day happened without me using my brain, and until today, I have no idea how or when I made it home. Fast forward a week. My now ex-girlfriend had literally moved out overnight. We only realized that she moved out because we didn't see her at the dinner table, so one of us went to see if she was okay and saw that there was a letter on her table which stated that she moved out overnight. Dumbfounded, we all looked at it and also saw that the only things she took with her were some of her clothes and her personal files. She left us with her entire furniture, her TV, computer, stereo, CDs, and DVDs, and wrote in the letter that she won't need those things anymore. So we ended up with a room full of furniture and electronics that nobody wanted, needed, or even had the room to store it. The new tenant wasn't planned to move in for at least 3 weeks, and the rent for her room this month wasn't paid either, so we had a little problem to deal with, but nothing we couldn't solve. At least that was what we thought. Cue the doorbell. Our landlord stood in the door and told us that our rental deposit account was emptied out this morning, and he demands to know why. I told him that as far as I knew, there were only two people that had a bank card for that account. One was with him, and the other one was in our rental folder. Our card had no permissions to withdraw any money from the account. Its only purpose was to get the bank statements, so the bank won't send us one via snail mail every month. I also told him that I worked from 8 p.m. until 4 a.m. in the morning and went straight to bed until roughly 10 a.m., so I have no idea what happened during that time frame. So we took a look into our rental folder, and yep, the card was still there. We also went to a computer to take a look at the account online, and yep, it was emptied out roughly 8 hours ago by card number 2. So the landlord and I went to the bank to ask how it was possible that someone is allowed to withdraw money from the account with a card that doesn't even have the permission to do so. The bank teller looked at our cards and told us right away that those were cards 1 and 3. The landlord and I just looked at each other with a look of disbelief on our faces. We instantly knew what was going on, and the bank teller confirmed it to us. Card number 2 belonged to my now ex-girlfriend, who opened the account 3 years ago, and the last time that card was used was at a bank roughly 300 kilometers away from us. We decided to get all the information in writing so we can take it to the police. After all, we were talking about a deposit of 3 rents for the whole flat, each 1,200 euros, and a credit line of 1,000 euros the bank had added without us knowing, which made a total of 4,600 euros, and there was no way we were letting her get away with that. But before we went to the police, I thought it would be a good idea to at least pay the rent for the month, since my landlord was already there and we both were at the bank. So I went to the ATM to see if all of my flatmates had paid their share of the rent. And guess what? Our rent account was emptied out too. But it wasn't only emptied out. It was also overdrawn to the maximum amount possible, which was 1 month's rent. Also, the money for our regular bills like water, power, etc. was missing, so she stole roughly 7,500 euros from us. I went pale and wanted to cry right there, because I was the one that had to tell it to my flatmates. So I bit the bullet and told them what happened. Two of them immediately blamed me for the whole mess and demanded that I pay all of it out of my own pocket. One just sat there and said nothing, and the last one just said that since he was moving out anyways, we shouldn't worry about the deposit and pay it back whenever we are able to. Which was an offer I couldn't refuse, so we ended up with a contract stating that we pay him back with small monthly rates. The real heroes, however, were the bank teller and our landlord. The bank teller told us that my ex-girlfriend was still an account holder on both accounts, and while he couldn't tell us officially that we can remove ourselves from the accounts, he dropped hints, left, right, and center that it is possible to do so. For example, he asked a coworker if there are any special rules to remove an account holder from an overdrawn account. The only rule that existed was that there had to be at least one active account holder left. So my landlord got himself removed from the deposit account, leaving my ex-girlfriend as the only account holder. And I, after voiding all cards, did the same with our rent account. Our landlord also told us that because of everything that had happened, he would refrain from collecting the rent that month and that we can take our time to refill the new deposit account. We were also able to work out a deal with our water and power provider, again, small rates, so the only thing we were behind was actually our phone bill. 5 months later, I received a call from ex-girlfriend. She was crying and yelling at the same time, which made it rather hard to understand her. But what I could gather from the call was, the bank had terminated the bank accounts since both were overdrawn for more than 3 months without any money movement, and they demanded impromptu payment of 2,200 euros plus interest, so roughly 2,400 euros. She wasn't able to pay this amount since she used the stolen money to rent a new flat for her and her boyfriend. Her boyfriend, however, found out what she did, probably after the first court order arrived, and moved out. Since she was pregnant and didn't work, she couldn't pay the rent anymore, and her newly ruined credit score kept her from getting a new, cheaper flat. And the only ones she could think of
that could maybe find it in their hearts to help her and forget what happened were us.
Her exact words. Her old flatmates that she screwed over. I still remember the exact words I said to her before hanging up and blocking her number. Me. Well, you already screwed 6 guys in one night. Maybe you should make a career out of it. Mr. Reddit, if you want to, put it in a video. Or just laugh at it.
Support this channel on Patreon, or I'm going to empty out all your bank accounts!
And congrats to our regenerals of the day, Catherine Gamer101 and Harold Norbert.
That's all for now, but don't be blue. I'll be back soon with more stories for you. Remember to listen to Mr. Reddit every night so your dreams will be wonderful like you are and bright.